Mode 1 alerts flight crews to excessive rates of descent when the aircraft is near terrain. Using radar altitude and rate of descent information, the ground proximity warning computer monitors the flight profile when an aircraft is within 2,500 feet of terrain. Should an excessive rate of descent develop for the aircraft's current altitude above ground level, the red GPWS warning lamp will illuminate and the voice alert sink rate will be heard.
Sink rate. Sink rate.
If the rate of descent continues or worsens, a continuous pull up voice warning will be heard.
Pull up. Pull up. Pull up.
As the aircraft recovers from the excessive rate of descent, the red GPWS warning lamp will extinguish and the voice warning will cease.
Mode 2 warns flight crews of excessive closure rates with rapidly rising terrain. Using airspeed, rate of descent, and radar altitude, GPWS compares terrain below the aircraft to the flight path. If terrain rises significantly within 2,000 feet of the aircraft, a closure rate is measured. When the closure rate shows danger to the aircraft, the red GPWS warning lamp will illuminate, and the voice alert terrain, terrain will be heard. If the closure rate continues or worsens, the voice call-out will change to a continuous pull-up warning until terrain is no longer a threat.
Terrain, 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 terrain. Pull up.
To help ensure sufficient recovery, the red GPWS warning lamp will remain illuminated until the aircraft climbs 300 feet above the altitude where the last pull-up voice warning was heard.
Mode 3 warns flight crews of inadvertent descents and loss of altitude after takeoff or during a missed approach. GPWS recognizes a takeoff or missed approach using aircraft speed, radar altitude, barometric altitude, and aircraft configuration changes. GPWS then monitors radar altitude and barometric altitude during the initial climbout. Should the aircraft descend, GPWS compares any loss of baro altitude to peak altitude gained. When this difference is roughly 10%, the red GPWS warning lamp will illuminate and the voice alert "Don't sink" will be heard.
Don't sink. Don't sink. Don't sink.
When a positive rate of climb is re-established, the red GPWS warning lamp will extinguish and the voice alert will cease. Once the aircraft has attained 1,000 feet above ground, Mode 3 is disabled. When GPWS again detects a takeoff or missed approach situation, Mode 3 protection is automatically re-enabled.
Mode 4 provides minimum terrain clearance protection in all phases of flight. GPWS will alert the flight crew to insufficient terrain clearance based on airspeed, altitude, rate of descent, and aircraft configuration. Mode 4 protection is especially valuable when the aircraft is on a normal flight path, where excessive descents or closure with terrain are not a factor. To understand the scope of Mode 4 alerts, let's follow a typical flight from takeoff to touchdown. As shown a few moments ago, Mode 3 protection is automatically enabled as the takeoff occurs. At the same time, Mode 4 begins to build a floor below the aircraft during climb out. This floor will continue to build under the aircraft until reaching roughly 800 feet above ground, where it will remain throughout the flight until the aircraft begins initial approach at the destination. If the aircraft penetrates this floor during the flight, the red GPWS warning lamp will illuminate and the voice alert "Too low terrain" will be heard.
Too low terrain. Too low terrain.
Once the aircraft is safely back above the protective floor, the red warning lamp will extinguish and the voice alert will cease. During the approach and landing, GPWS monitors airspeed and aircraft configuration. The minimum terrain clearance floor is automatically adjusted as airspeed is decreased. If landing gear is not down and locked at 500 feet above ground, the red GPWS warning lamp will illuminate and the voice alert "too low gear" will be heard.
Too low gear. Too low gear.
If flaps are not set to landing configuration by 170 to 250 feet, the red GPWS warning lamp will illuminate and the voice alert "too low flaps" will be heard.
Too low flaps. Too low flaps.
Pilots may elect to disable the flap alerts by engaging the flap override function either prior to or during a flap alert enunciation. This allows landings in configurations other than normal landing flaps with no GPWS flap alerts.
Mode 5 provides protection for inadvertent descent below a glide slope while on an ILS approach. GPWS monitors the flight path in relation to the glide slope centerline while on the ILS final approach course. The Mode 5 glide slope alert is enabled when a nav receiver is tuned to an ILS frequency and receiving a glide slope signal, landing gear is down, and radar altitude is less than 1,000 feet. Should the aircraft descend below the glide slope to a 1.3 dot fly-up indication, the amber GPWS glide slope alert lamp will illuminate, and the voice message "glide slope" will be heard.
Glide slope.
Glide slope voice messages are initially softer and less frequent than other GPWS alerts and warnings, but become louder and more frequent as the aircraft deviation below glide slope worsens.
Glide slope.
Once a correction is made by the pilot and the aircraft is returning to the glide slope centerline, the amber glide slope alert lamp will extinguish and the glide slope voice alert will cease. To allow repositioning below glide slope when visual conditions are achieved, or on localizer-only approaches, pilots may elect to disable the Mode 5 glide slope alert function. This is done by depressing the amber glide slope alert lamp or switch, either prior to or during a glide slope alert enunciation.
Mode 6 contains altitude and bank angle callout functions designed to increase situational awareness for the flight crew. These callouts are selected by the customer when GPWS is initially installed in the aircraft. The decision height minimums callout is a function of radar altitude. The pilot sets the radar altitude bug or DH manually, and GPWS provides the callout minimums at the selected altitude on the approach to landing.
Minimums.
Altitude callouts can be chosen from a large menu of possible combinations.
500.
These callouts are provided to pilots as a means to confirm aircraft position during approach.
100.
These callouts are just an example of one altitude callout menu. Bank angle callouts are designed to alert flight crews to the possibility of overbanking, which may lead to serious flight path deviation or loss of control. These callouts occur at preset maximum limits tailored to the aircraft type.
Bank angle.
Near the ground, radar altitude is used to advance the bank angle alert, so callouts are given sooner, providing additional time for pilot corrective action.
Bank angle.
The Mark 5 and Mark 7 GPWS offer detection and warning for encounters with wind shear up to 1,500 feet above ground. GPWS uses airspeed, radar altitude, barometric rate, angle of attack, air temperature, vertical and longitudinal acceleration, and aircraft-specific performance information to detect encounters with severe wind shear. When an aircraft first encounters the strong headwinds, decreasing tailwinds, and vertical updrafts associated with the outflow of microburst activity, the amber GPWS wind shear alert lamp will illuminate and remain on as long as the condition persists. Some installations will also enunciate the voice alert,
"Caution, wind shear."
If the aircraft enters the area of microburst activity where headwinds rapidly decrease, tailwinds increase, and vertical downdrafts become severe, The red GPWS wind shear warning lamp will illuminate. A short two-tone siren will be heard, followed by the voice warning.
Wind shear, wind shear, wind shear.
GPWS lamps and voice warnings will cease when the aircraft is no longer in the wind shear condition. Recovery should always continue to a safe altitude above terrain.